sir.
We have a...
Sir.
All right. Don't worry, we'll switch him around. LL, definitely want to welcome you here.
Thanks, man.
For stopping by and hanging out with us.
Glad to be here. You know? Man.
So I mentioned before that we're going to check out the Canadian premiere of your video.
Definitely.
Phenomenal, we got that. Cool. And as well, we got questions and all the rest of that stuff. But first of all, here's a book.
Yep.
I make my own rules. And I guess the first thing I want to ask you is you're still a young cat.
Yeah.
Why would you take this opportunity at this point in time in your life to actually, and you still have so much to accomplish, why would you take this point in time to actually write this book?
Well, I felt like it was an opportunity to touch some lives. I've been through a lot of rough things in my life. I've done some things I'm not too proud of and some things that I'm very proud of. And I felt like anybody who felt like life was hopeless or felt like they were in a situation that was overwhelming, maybe they wanted to give up, I wanted to show them, look, I've been in those types of situations too, and this is how I overcame those feelings. And I felt like that book was the perfect roadmap to show, you know, the young people what I've been through and how they can get through what they're going through.
You also talk about how the book has been therapeutic for you.
Oh, definitely. I mean, you know, it was real difficult for me to write the things that I wrote in the book. It was a definite healing process. It was hard to, you know, be honest. Sometimes the hardest person to be honest with is yourself. And I definitely had to do that in the book. So it was a healing process. I grew up a lot doing it, and I feel good about it.
What was the most, I mean, I found there's some parts in here I found it kind of difficult to read. Just knowing that if that happened to me,
I mean, you know,
how I deal with that. What was the most difficult part for you to actually to sit down and write?
I think the roughest part for me was the things that happened to my mother, my grandfather, them being shot at a young, you know, and me being 4 years old, having to see it, some of the other things that I've been through, that was real difficult for me. But it's not tragedy, it's not the traumatic events in your life, it's how you deal with them. That's what the key is. For me, being abused as a child, you know, 8, 9, 10 years old, being physically abused, getting beatings, all those type of things, it's not, I think that you gotta react the way a piece of coal reacts. You gotta, you know, become a diamond. A coal reacts to the pressure of the earth by either crumbling or becoming a diamond, and that's what I attempted to do. So, you know, you're gonna deal with a lot of rough things in your life. I'm sure some people here in the audience definitely have been through some rough things, felt like giving up, may have been abused or neglected or what have you, but the reality is that it's just about, you know, overcoming those feelings and striving to make it regardless of what you've been through, you know?
There's a point that I definitely got in the book is the fact that your deep spirituality for yourself, your family, and everyone that kind of surrounds you. But it takes, as you talked about, it takes a lot of pain and struggle to come to that realization.
Well, I mean, you know, it's a growing process. You don't learn overnight what your purpose is for being here, but once you discover your purpose, it makes life easy. I think the one thing about life is once you know it's hard, it makes it easier. And the first step in knowledge is knowing you need to know something. And knowing that led so you don't fall off the edge. So for me, you know, I just try to be as spiritual as possible. I try to give out the energy I want to give back. Try to treat people the way I want to be treated. Try not to degrade anybody, make anybody feel like, you know, walk away feeling less than when they came, you know? Try to make sure that everybody around me maintains their self-esteem so that I can maintain mine. And I think that's a part of spirituality. That's one of the first laws of the universe, cause and effect, you know?
Now, we're going to check out the video. I'm that type of guy.
Right.
Now, and every video and every album, there's a point in your life that you're actually going through stuff. So what were you going through?
I'm that type of guy?
Yeah.
I was that type of guy. It was the worst. It is what it is. It's self-explanatory, baby.
The video speaks for itself.
All right.
All right. Let's check out I'm that type of guy with LL Cool J. We're chilling with him right here on The Mix.
Supreme, and I'm notorious. I'll crush you like a jelly bean. I'm bad.
Testbed was last spotted with three other members of this group. A bobcat, a EM, a country, and they are extremely bad. So keep your eyes open.
Oh, yeah. Well, there you have it. Yes, give it up. Now, the one thing about Records, I mean, you represent it's FUBU, right?
Yeah.
You represent them. You got a new. You got Najee's Shoe Line coming out.
Yeah.
So you've always been an entrepreneur, and it seems very important for you to keep on striving.
Well, I think it's important that, you know, whenever I get a chance to like embrace, like these fellas are from the community where I grew up at, and they told me, you know, we got this clothing line, and when they first brought me the shirts, I wasn't feeling them. It was ugly, you know what I'm saying? And they just started like bringing me more stuff, and you know, I just felt like I wanted to support them. And then when I did the Gap commercial, the Gap even let me support them a little more, which I think was, you know, the Gap should be commended for. And it's been cool, you know, just trying to do different things. Like my book is actually, you know, on my book company. And then, you know, I just try to make it happen as many possible.
There you go.
I like that view. No, it was, you know, actually, it's just an opportunity to do something different and support some cats in the community. And I think that's important, you know? At the end of the day, you want to help people out, give a helping hand, so it's cool.
Okay.
And plus, we try to make it happen.
All right, we have a caller on the line. It's Melissa. Melissa from Halifax. How you doing?
Pretty good.
All right. What's your question?
First off, I just want to tell LA that I love him. I think he's the greatest.
Oh, thank you. Appreciate that.
And my question is, I know you must have been affected by the death of Tupac and Notorious B.I.G., and I was just wondering how you stay positive and manage to stay clear of the negativity that's associated with the rap industry.
Well, I think that, you know, I think tragedy as a whole affects everybody, whether it's the death of Tupac and Biggie, Prince, you know, Princess Diana, Enes Cosby, no matter who it is. I mean, you know, people in your family, people who aren't famous. I mean, you know, it's just a matter of just trying to stay focused. In between confidence and cocky, there's focus. Because confidence can wear away, cockiness is blind, and focus is relentless, you know? So I just try to stay as positive as possible, you know, and give out the energy I want to give back. And all the love I'm receiving today, I try to give it back, and that way we all stay afloat. You know, and I want to send, you know, my condolences out to their families, you know, and I just hope that, you know, we can all learn from this, and you realize that anytime you say something, know what you're saying and know the repercussions, because it's cause and effect. So, you know, for every action, it's equal opposite reaction. So let's just be careful and know what we're doing.
All right, cool.
Thanks.
All right, right now, we're going to, in this pack of tracks, we're actually going to check out Hey Lover, which is your biggest single to date.
All right.
In terms of success and everything.
Okay.
And also, you have a video pick. You want to check out, which video was it? Buster, right?
Yeah, let me see Buster.
You want to see the new? You want to check out the new joint?
Yeah,
all right, cool. So we're going to do the LL's pick right now. Still chilling with him.
With the drums and all that.
Satin doll.
I think you're so fine. What does your wife think about all the attention you've been getting? And plus, your wife, I mean, is obviously, throughout the book, you really find out how much you guys are spiritually connected, and because you've gone through a lot together.
Yeah,
so how does she deal with all this stuff?
Supportive. She's supportive. I don't give her no reason to not be. Just work hard, you know? Supportive, definitely, real supportive. She gives a lot of love. She gives a lot of love. And she's understanding because I got to do what I got to do. In terms of my videos and my music, I still have to make what I make and make what I feel. But, you know, very supportive. Keep the home tight. It's all good.
All right, cool.
All beautiful, baby.
We've got some
Thank
gifts. Come on over here. Gifts.
Hello, love you.
Okay, what's your name? All right, cool.
Aisha.
Okay,
Ivor. Ivor, Polygram. We just want to say that last time LL was here, we didn't get a chance to give you a reward. Mr. Smith, we've got a gold, but it's now gone platinum. And All Worlds also gone gold. And Ooh. Phenomena out October 14th. We're going to give you platinum for that, too.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh, man. Oh, thank you, baby.
All right, come here. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Now, next time you come, mm-hmm. I don't care what it takes, live vocals, you can perform, do your thing.
Make it hot.
Make it hot, baby.
Make it hot.
And I know a lot of people want to know, why the one pant leg? I've got to ask that question.
Well, now, at first it was just a fashion statement from New York, but now I got like these different tattoos that mean different things on my leg. Presence of God and God's protection, bravery and fearlessness, creativity, wisdom, and the complexities of life, and quite a few others.
All the best, man. Thank you for hanging with the children. Right now, here is Phenomenon. You're going to tear it up. LL Cool J.